The Heart of the Nick Collection is its patented single-click selection method called U-Point technology. Using the U-Point technology, you can select an object simply by clicking on it. The selection you get gives photorealistic results. The U-Point technology makes photographic editing fast, as we will see in the next lecture. In this lecture, we will explore the interface of the Nick software and start with making global adjustments. In the next lecture, we will look at local adjustments using the U-Point technology. I have opened Beach. The image is overexposed. I will open the image in Nick's Vivesa 2 plugin. To open the image in Vivesa, I go to Filters, Google Nick Collection. In the window that opens, behind Program, I can choose a plugin. Define 2, which is a powerful noise removal plugin, is shown by default. I click on it, and from the drop-down list, I choose Vivesa 2. Behind Layer, I will leave New from Visible selected. This way, I will not overwrite my image, but I will get a new layer with the adjustments on it. I click on OK. When Vivesa opens, you can press F to work in full screen mode. At the right, we see four sliders: brightness, contrast, saturation, and structure. The structure slider is developed by Nick Software, and we will look at it in a moment. If I click on the Expand All Sliders icon, I get six more sliders. You can use all sliders. To get a slider back to 0%, just double-click on the triangle. Warmth works the same way as the temperature slider found in programs like Lightroom. Dragging it to the left makes the image look colder. Dragging it to the right makes the image look warmer. With shadow adjustments, you can brighten up the darker areas of an image, like the trees here. With structure, you are able to control the amount of detail that is visible in an image. Let's see what structure can do for our overexposed background. I drag it to the right. To toggle between a 100% view and seeing the whole image, I double-click on the image. When I press the spacebar, I see a hand appearing. With the spacebar pressed down, I can pan through the image by dragging. Clicking on the image with the spacebar pressed down also gives me a before and after view. And at the top, I can also click on Preview. As we can see, Structure is a powerful tool. I double-click again to zoom out. On the bottom right, I will click on Save. In GIMP, I now have a new layer with the adjusted image. I press Ctrl-1 to see the image at 100%. Let's compare the sand. If I drag the top layer a bit to the right, we can see the difference that structure has brought. In the next lecture, we will start making local adjustments.